No, I'm not going to talk about the president's State of the Union address. I don't think it's really relevant anymore. It's just propaganda. And frankly, speeches aren't going to add jobs. Speeches aren't going to put food on the table. It's just rhetoric. But payrolls decreased in 35 states last month, and China's largest bank is going to be taking over some U.S. banks. Hey guys, it's January 26, 2011. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dimcad. Payrolls decreased in 35 states last month. New York was the largest with 22,800 jobs cut last month. Minnesota with 22,400 firings. Florida lost 17,900 jobs. This is the real story, not rhetoric coming from politicians. GM's China sales passed U.S. for the first time in history. For the first time in history, there's more cars being sold by GM in China than in the U.S. That is incredible. It shows how the world has become more global in a sense that, it shows you how China has transformed as a nation. They're relying a lot more on vehicles. However, Toyota is still number one. They sold 8.42 million vehicles worldwide last year. They're still number one, but only by a hair, We'll see how long they stay at the top. Toyota, they recalled 1.7 million vehicles. Now, is it just me, or does it seem too often that they're always recalling vehicles? I mean, you could say that at least they're trying to fix the mistakes that they make, but then on the other hand, you know, I mean, how come there's so many mistakes? I mean, maybe it's just my perception. Maybe it just appears in the media differently. Airlines, path to profits. Basically, they're offering less flights and they're charging people more money. While TSA molests them and their children. I had to mention TSA. But you know, one of the strategies they did was, besides adding fees, and they added a lot of fees, they also cut away at those gas-guzzling older airplanes. They got rid of them, so that also helped them save some money. They also eliminated some flights that just weren't earning a lot of money for them. They also merge a lot. There's some consolidation. Delta Airlines bought Northwest in 2008, and United and Continental united, so they combined. So we went from having six major ones to just four. So okay, profits it's just up at McDonald's, but the prices will too. Now, some of you are wondering, well, why do I care about this? You should care because if their costs are going to rise 2 to 2.5% this year, then it means that there's some forces in the food market that's causing them to do that. That's only the U.S. In Europe, the prices, the costs are actually going to go up 3.5 to 4.5. So, obviously, the prices of various foods are starting to affect even McDonald's. Okay, judge throws out a ban on online ammo sales in California. Basically, there was a new law that Arnold Schwarzenegger signed last year. The California Handgun Ammunition Registration Bill pretty much made it impossible. It banned online sales of handgun ammunition. But a judge struck it out. It just threw it out, and rightfully so. How can a guy who makes so much money off of action movies using guns or props, you know, be so anti-gun? I mean, isn't that kind of hypocritical? It doesn't make any sense. Donate $1 a day to a new charity. A website has come up with a really brilliant idea. My question is, how many of these dollars are actually going to go to the actual charity? And if you want to know why I'm so cynical about it, check out my last video. Well, the video before that one, when I was talking about charities in Africa. a lot of it went to fraud, but anyway, where exactly is this money going to... How can you have any confidence that this money will actually go to the right charities? And how much will actually go to the actual cause that you think you're giving to? Only 47% of working-age Americans have full-time jobs. But when you look at the amount of employed people, there's 139 million employed people. That's 58.3% of the labor force. It's very important to remember the labor force because a lot of times the government calculates a lot of people who aren't working as not being a part of the labor force. The unemployed people, 14.5 million people, about 14.5 million people, is 6.1% of the labor force, according to their stats. And there's the part-time people, which these are people who are part-time for economic reasons. They couldn't really find a job that could really support them full-time. There's 8.9 million of these people. So when you calculate the unemployed, the part-time, and the part-time employed for non-economic reasons, now those people are 18 million people. The reason why I would actually include the part-time employed people for non-economic reasons is because even if they are retired and on Social Security, obviously they feel as though they need a job for some reason. They need some type of income. Now, granted, a lot of those people just want to work just so they have something to do. However, a lot of these people are dealing with family issues that are actually linked to economic reasons. But either way, even if you exclude that group, you have 14.5 million people not working. You have almost 9 million people who are working part-time for economic reasons. These are some really serious numbers. And this is what I mean by the real story. This is more important than speeches. China's largest bank, the Industrial and Commercial Bank of China, is going to be, if this deal goes through, they're going to be taken up. They're actually going to have a majority stake in the Bank of East Asia, American banks. So this is pretty interesting right here. We haven't really seen anything like this before. They're going to take over 13 branches in New York and California. Wow. How do you feel about that? Question of the day. What do you think about the President's State of the Union Address? Do you care? What did you take from it? Do you think it's going to go in a different direction? And please tell me what you think about all these other stories. All right. Have a good day. Don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Don't forget to rate. Bye.